after getting rejected for asking a copy of President Duterte's statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth. A lawyer is now seeking the document directly from the chief executive. Our correspondent Mike Navarro joins us now for an update on that. Mike, go ahead.
Hi, Carmina. The lawyer was given the runaround. This bid to secure the president's statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth, or SALEN, went straight to the source and challenged Mr. Duterte himself to release the SALEN or issue an authorization. Lawyer Dino De Leon, in a letter dated September 10, pressed the president to reconsider the earlier decision of the Malacanang Records Office, referring him to the office of the ombudsman. De Leon's earlier request was turned down, citing a memorandum circular issued in 2012 from the Office of the Ombudsman that requires all requests for the president's SALEN should be coursed through the ombudsman as the official repository. But the ombudsman in July denied De Leon's request, referring to a more recent memorandum circular requiring a notarized authorization from the public official who filed the SALEN. So in his letter, De Leon asked the president that if he cannot issue or provide his SALEN, to issue him a notarized authorization so that he can gain access to the salary of the president from the office of the ombudsman. De Leon had earlier told ENC he will look at possible legal remedies, which could include going to court. He also raised the possibility of impeaching Martire, saying his actions in hindering transparency could be considered betrayal of public trust, an impeachable offense. Lawyer Christian Monsod, one of the framers of the 1987 Constitution, said yesterday, Ombudsman Samuel Marquez's memorandum circular, in effect, limited access to silence only to public officials, which are not the public contemplated under the Constitution. The Right to Know Right Now Coalition noted, this is the first time an ombudsman has restricted access to silence and had proposed jail time against those who would comment on silence. The Constitution requires the president and other high-ranking officials to disclose their silence to the public. And in fact, President Duterte signed an executive order in 2016 reminding public officials to disclose their silence at the start of his term. Mr. Duterte did not release his silence starting 2018, according to efforts made by the Philippine Center for Investigative Journalism. In his letter, De Leon challenged Mr. Duterte, given your claim that you are for transparency and against corruption, I look forward to your positive response within 5 days from receipt of the letter. We are still seeking the side of Malacanang, Carmina, and we will update you on that once we receive word from Malacanang. Carmina?
Right. Thanks a lot, Mike. Take care and you keep safe.